is the diastasis of rectus muscles.
Hi guys, I'm Dr. Andrew Iraniha from Surgical Oasis Institute. Today I'm going to talk to you about diastasis recti. It's a very common condition and I have a lot of patients asking questions about what that is and what are the different types and how they present. So if you look at the top of this slide, you can see the normal anterior abdominal wall anatomy. Actually, in the front of the abdomen, we have two very thick, very strong muscles called rectus muscles. And those muscles are attached into the ribcage on the upper abdomen and then in the lower abdomen attached to the pubic portion of the pelvic bone. And they are very, very critical in creating our core muscle strength. These two muscles are inside the sheath called rectus sheath. They basically surrounded by this white sheath that you can see in the anterior abdominal wall, and they connected right in the center with a very thick tissue called linea alba, and that actually create that midline appearance in the athletes with a space between two rectus abdominis muscles. Now, for any reason, whether it's obesity or multiple pregnancies, if this linea alba or this white line gets completely stretched out and thinned down, you can see this appearance happens. So the rectus muscles separate from each other, and this linea alba, which was the size of a line, it turns to a very thin sheet. And even though there's no actual defect, but because it's very thin, when patients stand up or crunches, you can get this very big vertical sausage-shaped bulge in the anterior abdominal wall. And that's called diastasis recti, or separation of the rectus muscles. What that does, it in some of the patients, actually creates some abnormal posture of the body and trunk, and create pressure over the back, and some of the patients complain of back pain. Other patients, they present with not only this bulge, but also associated periumbilical hernia, so they can see the eversion of the umbilicus with the distortion of the umbilical area. So a lot of patients with a diastasis recti associated with a periumbilical hernia, which can actually have potential of problems. The other signs and symptoms of the patients with a diastasis recti is instability of their abdominal wall core muscles. So when they do exercise, they feel abnormal or discomfort in the abdominal wall. So in the past, a lot of patients did not have any symptoms, but recently we see a lot of people present with those abnormalities. And if you look at the bottom of this slide, you can see the different extent of the diastasis recti, or variations of diastasis recti. For example, this patient is a normal patient. You can see the rectus abdominis on both sides are kissing each other in the center with a white line. And then here in this patient, you have the separation of the rectus muscle mostly around the umbilical region. But this patient, most of the diastasis happens in the lower abdomen. Some of the patients present with the diastasis mostly in the upper abdomen. And then in some patients, it's diffuse from the top to the bottom. Regardless of the type of the diastasis recti, these patients, they present also with the pouchiness of the abdomen. So when they stand up, they have a little bulge, and especially is very obvious in very thin people that they don't have that much extra fat, and when they stand up, it affects their abdominal wall appearance and their posture. So there are a lot of different techniques to fix this abnormality. And if you're interested, you can call my office for free consultations at 949-646-8444. Go to my YouTube channel at Surgical Oasis Institute and see a very more detailed discussion and videos of my surgeries, and also discussions about how we fix the diastasis recti. Thank you.